If you have a job that you're truly happy with, one that allows you to use your strengths every day and really realize your full potential, consider yourself very fortunate. Research by Gallup shows that only 20% of people that are working today have a job that really allows them to use their strengths every day to help them be successful. And that's really a waste. When you think about the fact that the average working adult spends over 100,000 hours working through their career, if they're working in a job that's not fulfilling, that doesn't utilize the strengths, that doesn't allow them to express their passion, they've wasted a lifetime, nearly 100,000 hours. So one of the things we want to do is really determine what our strengths are, what differentiates us from other people that provides value. And there are certain techniques, there are certain tools that we can use to enable us to do that. The biggest problem, though, is most people say, you know, Rich, I simply don't have time. I'm too busy with my day-to-day work, with my personal life, to actually sit down and think about what I want to do and where I want to go in life. And that's a shame. When you consider the average Facebook user spends about 23 hours a month browsing the website, and the average fantasy football player spends about 6 hours a week planning for their game, it's a shame that we simply can't carve out time to really think about the most important thing, which is our life. You know, it seems like the 1980s, the motto was greed is good with the movie Wall Street and Michael Douglas. But that motto, greed is good, seems to have been replaced by the motto, speed is good, where we equate busyness with productivity. And it simply doesn't mean it's the case. When you look at the fact that most people love to get that adrenaline rush from activity, bouncing around like a bumper car from one thing to the other without really stopping and really saying, what do I want to do? And where am I today? Where do I want to go? You know, the same tools that we use in business to help us create a business plan or a marketing plan or a strategic plan, things like SWOT analysis, strategy profiles, those same types of tools can be applied to you as an individual. And that's what I've done in the book Strategy for You. I've taken the principles of business strategy and for the first time applied them on an individual level. And in the book, you'll see plenty of examples and stories and anecdotes of people that have used these strategy models, these strategy concepts and tools to really improve their lives, to make them more happy, more fulfilling, more satisfying. So one of the things we want to walk away with is this idea of doing new things. There's a simple but often overlooked premise in life, and that is new growth comes from new thinking. If we're simply doing the same things in the same ways that we've always done them, as the motto goes, we're going to get the same things that we've always received in the past. In order to find new, exciting ways to use your talents in life, you've got to have new ways to think about what you're going to do. And so new growth in your life comes from new thinking. And in the book Strategy for You, we give you new concepts, new ways, new tools to think about your life and how it can be improved, enhanced, honed, and really made into the life that you want. You know, too many people wind up in jobs because an opportunity arose that didn't necessarily match up with what they wanted to do, but they still took it anyway. And that led to another job and another job, and pretty soon they've spent 15, 20 years in a career that they never really wanted. We want to try and prevent that. We want to give people of all ages a way to get to the life that they really want. And in the book Strategy for You, the main analogy I use is strategy as a bridge. If you're trying to get from one side of a ravine to another, you use a bridge. A bridge generally doesn't just happen. It has to be thought through, the terrain has to be analyzed, the dimensions have to be understood, the materials have to be selected. There's a lot of thought that goes into building a bridge. The same thing can be said for strategy. Strategy is how we get from where we are today to our goals or where we want to go. Strategy is that bridge. And just like a physical bridge takes time and effort to build, so does a strategy for your life. It's not just going to happen. You're not just going to fall into the great life that you've always imagined. You've got to put some thought into it, and you've got to design a plan to help get you there. And so we can do that by following the five steps in the book, Strategy for You.